Hello, welcome here to Uckfield Rectory. We're back in the garden on one of the last lovely days of the year. Sophie is here to welcome you in, and it's good to be with you. I'm Father John, I'm the Rector of Uckfield, and welcome to my home. Let's begin with the prayer for the 17th of October. God, our light and our salvation, illuminate our lives, that we may see your goodness in the land of the living, and looking on your beauty, may be changed into the likeness of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The reading today is from St. Mark, Mark 10:35-45. James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came forward to him and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." And he said to them, "What is it you want me to do for you?" And they said, "Grant us to sit, one on your right hand and one on your left, in your glory." Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you're asking. Are you able to drink the cup that I drink, or be baptized with the baptism that I'm baptized with?" They replied, "We are able." Then Jesus said to them, "The cup that I drink, you will drink. And with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right hand or my left is not mine to grant, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared." When the 10 heard this, they began to be angry with James and John. So Jesus called them and said to them, "You know that among the Gentiles, those whom they recognize as their rulers lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. But it's not so among you. But whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you must be slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." I really wanted to talk directly to those of you who are watching today. We've been doing these services online now for about the last 18 months. We sort of crash landed, as a lot of churches did, and we'd never have dreamed of doing stuff online. And we've, for the last year or so, have done the same format. The wonderful Off the Wall have filmed us, and we're hugely grateful to them. I think we've, as things are starting to ease back, and churches are open, far more people are starting to go back to church. But I know there's still very much a faithful band of people who watch these services that we broadcast. You are part of our family, you are part of our church community, and we value you. We want, though, to know where we're going to go after with these. We're changing the format, hence I'm actually back in the rectory garden for the first time in about a year, on one of the last beautiful sort of late summer days, autumn days that we have. It would be really useful to know what you think and what you would like us to do. If you could make contact with us, either commenting on Facebook, or else if you could email me. My email is uckfieldrector@gmail.com. It would be really helpful to know, because as I said, you are part of our church community, and we want to be there for you and continue to do stuff online, but it would be really useful to know what. Communities are strange things, and as we heard in the Gospel, where you've got James and John, who are sort of trying to get one over on the other disciples. They're all part of a family that had come together, and Jesus was patient and loving with them. We are a family, and we want to continue with being a channel of love for people. And it will be really good to hear from you. So may you have a wonderful week. And so now, let us pray.
Our Father in heaven, we are eternally grateful to you for the gift of your Son, which made it possible for us to understand more fully your love for us and the important guidance you give to us during our time on earth. From his birth until his death, he and all those around him understood the importance and responsibility of the messages and teachings he conveyed on your behalf. He always made it clear to everyone who listened that he would join you in eternal life and showed us that there is life after death for us all. In the name of Jesus Christ, Amen. Today, Lord, on this International Day for the Eradication of Poverty, we remember the millions of people living in poverty, struggling to survive, not just in third world countries, but in Britain and other so-called wealthy nations. Let us contribute whatever and whenever we can, with love and support, and be filled with gratitude for the comparative comfort we enjoy in our lives. We pray that governments and leaders give due thought and care when forming policies and laws to the plight of the poorest and most vulnerable people, so that they go some way to eliminate poverty in their countries and help them to understand that by doing so it will benefit the stability and development of all levels of society. Most merciful Father, hear our prayer. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
May God, who loves you, walk with you every step of your lifetime's journey, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and everyone you love, now and always. Amen. Goodbye.